Anyway, guys, welcome. Somebody asked, why are you not in the Mod Workshop studio? Because this is Intel Live Mod Workshop, not Mod Workshop Intel Live. So we're in the Intel Live part. So that's where we're going to be going from here. So this is where the show will be from now on. And very, very excited. And huge shout out, not just to obviously Intel, right? Because we got Alex here, but also NZXT, who is going to be a proud sponsor of today's episode. We're going to be using NZXT parts. So, okay, so let's walk through. And again, we'll show all of this stuff again. So Intel Core Ultra 7 265K. The one thing I really, really love about this CPU, the price. It's like the price for this thing is ridiculously low right now. The other thing too is that at 1440p and at 4K, in terms of performance differentiation, what you don't get is like from the gaming stuff, there's a lot of people who don't understand that for gaming, 1440p and 4K, what this ends up giving you a boost for is basically for your productivity. And for productivity, you cannot beat this for this price, which is actually crazy. This is where I was telling you about. Dude, Alex, look at the RGB on this thing. This is the NZXT N9 Z890. And you can see here, look at that is RGB. The one thing that's so nice about NZXT boards is they end up being super, super clean, right? And so when they all kind of come together, and yes, we're using a white board inside of a black build, but again, it's some, one of the things I do like about this is it does a good job of making the other components pop. And you'll see that a little bit when we get done. And then we for RAM, we talked about this 6400 mega transfer CL32. This is 6400 32 gigs, which is great. So that runs beautifully. For gaming, we got to make sure there's enough room to install Battlefield and all of those other games, right? So 2 terabyte Western Digital Black SN850X. This does have DRAM, so we basically will still get your caching and all that sort of stuff, which is great. For cooling, we're gonna have more than enough cooling for the CU, the 265K. This is the Kraken Elite 360 RGB. This is their V2 2024 edition. It has their core, their 120 cores on it, which is a 360 millimeter all unified fan. For the power though, we're gonna be using the C750 bronze PSU, which is more than enough power for our RTX 5070. So like these, it's not a modular PSU. I think we're actually supposed to be using a C850, but I guess we're using a C750 from NZXT and stuff like that. So we're gonna have more than enough power there. And then lastly, we're using the PNY RTX 5070. The reason that we're using PNY, one of the things that I love to do when I choose parts and all that sort of stuff is looking for things that if I can match motherboard to GPU, then you can. We're trying to minimize the amount of RGB, knowing that we want to control as much as we can with CAM, so we don't have a lot of actual extra resident programs on there to control RGB and all that stuff. So what you're getting is just pure power. And then lastly, we have this, which is brand new. The NZXT H9 FLOW. There it is right there. So the NZXT H9 FLOW. This case was just debuted at Computex. It can support up to a 420 millimeter AIO at the top. Airflow on it is fantastic.
NZXT, it's just gorgeous.
And then now I'm just gonna build the PC real quick.
1, 2, 3, go, and let me
done.
Time you.
Done, turn it on. Oh, it doesn't work. I thought this is all we had to do. Wait, Alex, you didn't tell me you have to take up. I thought you could just put the boxes in there and all that.
I think there's some cables. I heard there's cables in it and something about a toothpaste.
I saw some cables in the back already. I mean, those were in there. I cable managed. It looks really clean back there right now. I don't know what the problem is. Okay, here we go, guys. Starting with this beautiful motherboard here. And dude, this thing is, man, I mean, like it's just very clean. Nice looking board, NZXT, nice looking board. You ready? Are you ready? Okay, here we go. Are we gonna get a pop though, is the question. I don't know. I don't know. We'll see. Not very far. Okay, beautiful RAM. The other thing too is I don't think people know this about RAM, Alex. Something that people aren't aware of is that RAM can also be used as a self-defense weapon should you be attacked in your home? So like, say for instance, like, let's just click this in, you know what I mean? You just click it in like this, right? And it's there. But then all of a sudden, let's say Brian is an intruder, right? Check this out. You just go over to your system, you take off the glass, you eject your RAM, and now you've got a knife. I'm just saying, like, this, why is this not marketed? Because I could defend myself. I mean, come at me, Brian. Okay, 3, 2, 1. Oh, that's good clicks, though. Those are good clicks. That was a good click. Okay, one more here. Okay, let's get this one open, this big Gen 5 slot. I like to make sure that I have lots of room when I unscrew screws on my case. There we go. It feels like I got enough room there. There we go. So I'm doing the USB-C right now, which I always guess wrong, but I didn't that time, so there we go. There we go, okay, so there we go. So I use those back connects to make it hide, and so it just ends up looking way cleaner that way. Okay, so now all of our front panels are connected. So here's the build as it looks now. By the way, it does not work yet, just so you know. Even though I connected all of the connections, it does not actually work. But I think, what do you guys think? It looks pretty good, right? So you just gotta plug this. So let's check it out. Big, giant cold plate with very, very generous thermal paste on it, which I'm actually a big fan of. This is always the part where I have to concentrate. But here we go, here we go, here we go. Oh, man, that is stinky. One day I'm gonna smell one and it's gonna smell like roses. I'm gonna be really happy. Has yet to happen. Okay, so let's get here, so CPU. There we go. Time for our 24 pin. Then we have our other PCI, so this is for the power, for the hub. Okay, here we go, guys. Putting in our PNY GPU now. Intel Live, there it is, right there. That looks cute, that looks beautiful. Okay. Oh, boom. Look at that. That was a nice click. Zit up. Time to put the top on. So we're gonna plug this in. Gonna plug this in. Gonna plug that in. Okay, let's get your PC is ready to turn on. 3, 2, 1. Oh, that would be, forget to turn the power supply on. Okay, let's do that again. Let's put the choke on. Turn on the gas, please. 3, 2, 1. Oh, whoa, that is so much light. Wow. Failed. Well, this one is not peeling very well. Oh, that was good though. Okay, so we're gonna load it up. This is that weird song. Okay, temperature package right now is right there. Run for 10 minutes. Okay, so let's show you guys airflow for this. So you can see here, that's gonna pull some from the back, right? You can see it pulled up and through to the seat, the AIO, right? Which is really, really nice. And then also you can see airflow here. So you can see how, I think a lot of people don't understand just how quickly air travels through a case, because it travels through really fast. So when people say warm air rises, your air doesn't stay in the case that long. So it's being pulled quite quickly. So that'll give you an idea in just in terms of how airflow works for the PSU and all that sort of, for the CPU and the case. So it's definitely pulling intake from the side, intake from the bottom, and then exhaust through the back, the top, and the rear. So there you go. And then looking at our temperatures, you can jump over to capture. Looks like our temperature right now is 75 degrees. So again, no problem with thermals whatsoever on this system at all. So it's not gonna have any issues whatsoever with thermals on this. So there you go. Okay, guys, well, that is it for us. Bye, Alex. Bye, guys.
Bye, my friends.